Hello guys, welcome to the Web Epic channel. In this video, we'll learn how you can merge multiple attributes by using the attribute mapping functionality. So without further ado, let's jump into our site and learn how exactly we can do this. To merge multiple attributes together, you can use the attribute mapping functionality. So scroll down and find attribute mapping. Here, click on add new mapping. Now here you gotta put in the attribute name that you want to create, use the attribute separator and select the attributes that you wanna merge. Let's say for example, we want to use these two products and we want to combine the product ID and the SQ. Let's do it for the heels as well. Let's combine the product ID and SQ together to create a custom attribute. So go back to attribute mapping, let's say ID. Let's name this ID and SKU. For separator, let's use a dash. And this is what's gonna be in between the two attributes. So for the first one, I'll choose product ID. To add new one, click on add new row. Once you've done that, scroll down and find the next attribute, which is SKU in my case. Let's click on that and save mapping. There we go. It's as easy as that. We already have one attribute merged together. Let's create another one just so that you get a hang of how exactly we can use this. Let's say add another mapping. Now let's say I want to create an attribute that describes the product title a bit better and more in description. So let's name this descriptive product title. For the attribute separator, I'm going to keep it as blank, which will automatically put a space in between the different attributes. So let's say the first thing I want to add is season. Let's add another one. And let's say the gender so that we know who the product is for. And now, last but not least, we'll add the product title. There we go. So save mapping. There we go. Now we already have two different attributes ready. Let's go ahead and implement this in our feed. Let's add this new attribute into one of our existing feed. I'll use custom one for now. Let's scroll down and go add new attribute. Let's name the first one ID and SKU. And now we'll look for the attribute that we've just created. There we go, ID and SKU. Let's put this right after here. So I'm guessing we can use one of these attributes for tracking or some other purposes. And let's add another one. Actually, as a matter of fact, we're going to replace our product title with the new one that we have created. Let's go find the attribute, descriptive product title. There we go. Now we'll have a little bit more information in our title. Let's go ahead, update and generate feed. Once that's ready, let's go ahead and download it and have a look. There you go. As expected, we can see our ID and SKU showing up with our separator as you have configured it. And the title now is showing a bit more description as well. We can see the season. We can see who it's for, which is male, and we can see sneaker. Similarly, it has worked for the other products as well. Now, if we wanted, we can also add a static value to our attribute mapping. To add a static value, all you have to do is type it in. Let's say I'm going to add brand new. As you can see, brand new does not exist as an attribute. So I'm just going to click on add brand new. Then I'm going to add my next one, which is season, which is an attribute that we already have. And then let's add another static value. Let's say I'm going to add cool. As you can see, cool is not there. So I'm going to click on add cool. There we go. And then we're going to, let's go ahead and add the gender. There we go. And let's go add new, and last but not the least, we can add the product title. Let's save mapping. As you can see right here, we have two static values and we've got attributes that's being pulled from our products. Let's go ahead and save this mapping. Now let's see how it looks in our feed. Let's go back to our feed, refresh it, and have a look. There you go guys. As you can see on the title, we can see brand new, which is a static value that we have added. Then we've got the season, which is winter, which is an attribute. Cool is a static value. And then we've got gender and the product title afterwards. There you go, guys. Now you know how to merge multiple attributes by using attribute mapping. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webappic.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.